That was a little sloppy. Hello, and welcome to Fender Play Live. I'm your host this week, Eugene Edwards, coming to you live from my home in Los Angeles. We're continuing to bring you Fender Play Live despite being completely remote, so bear with us through any technical glitches. This week, we're taking a look at the queen of country, none other than Dolly Parton. We're going to be unpacking some of her biggest hits and taking a look at her style and influence, and we'll be featuring some special performances by our guest who's coming to you live from Nashville. We also have some really fun giveaways and discounts just for you viewers throughout the episode, so please stick around. But first, please welcome, live from Nashville, my guest, Jaime Wyatt.
Hey, Eugene, how you doing?
I'm doing really well, and you know, as I was saying earlier, you and I know a lot of people in common, and it's just kind of bizarre that we're actually meeting this way with some people watching.
Right? So, it's awesome.
Look great. You look great. It sounds great there. How's Nashville treating you?
It's great. Yeah, it's totally cool, man. Weather's pretty good. It's starting to get humid, but not too bad yet.
Yeah. Look out for those allergies there around this time of year. Jaime is a country music singer, songwriter, and guitarist, and she's got a brand new album on New West Records coming out very, very soon. We'll be getting into that. Here's a question we ask every new guest. How long have you been playing guitar?
Actually, I got my first guitar, so I've probably been playing for somewhere just under 30 years.
That's a long time. You've pretty much had a guitar in your hands your whole life. Let's put it that way.
Especially since I'm only 30 years old, right?
I'm joking. It's an appendage.
So I got my first guitar, which was actually a Fender electric guitar. I got it when I was 5 or 6, and it was a Fender Duosonic. And it was like a 50s cool. Duosonic. Yeah, it was super cool.
Was that like a family guitar? Or
I have my folks found it at like a somewhere thrifting. Perfect. And and then they gave me like a little Fender amplifier, the one that clips on your belt. Yeah, they were very patient because I did not know any chords. No. Like, I was just, like, blasting it, like, having that amp clipped on my belt and, like, around the house, like, just jamming.
Perfect. You can't trade that time. And what's your listening to Dolly Parton? Do you remember when you first heard her or what your experience has been listening to her?
I just think Dolly Parton is absolutely... aptly titled the Queen of Country Music. And not only is she like an incredible songwriter and singer, she's also like just an angelic humanitarian. Mm-hmm. She came on TV a few years back when there was some fires in the Smoky Mountains, and like just this angelic creature is like on the television, and it was Dolly Parton. She had like given like $2,000 to every family in the Smoky Mountains. Like, she is literally a saint in my opinion, because not only has she like written these gorgeous, beautiful songs and natural talent, but that she's also like lovely.
Yeah, you know? It's
very generous.
And it's very rare, but she at around these times, but she seems to be the one thing upon which we still agree.
Yeah, exactly. That's true. Yes.
Not easy to do. Also, and just this philanthropy, this week, she won Tennessean of the Year. I'm going to pretend like we knew that and we planned this.
The best.
So before we jump in, if you guys have any questions for myself or Jaime throughout the episode, drop them in the comments and we'll try to answer them for you. Also, if you want to get that lovely hat that's hanging right here, see this hat right here? And by the way, this says West Coast. And I know you're in Nashville, but you're a Pacific Northwest and Southern California gal. So
that's right.
This hat right here, we're offering a special discount to you viewers. You can get 30% off by using the promo code Jolene, Jolene. It's only valid for 24 hours, so check it out at the link in the description. Let's kick this episode off with a tune. On Fender Play, we have 4 songs by Dolly Parton that you can learn today on Fender Play, and they are all classic Dolly tunes, big hits. So let's kick it off with none other than Jolene by Jaime Wyatt.
All right. Okay. Jolene. Jolene, 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 Jolene. Oh, please don't take him just because you can. Your beauty is beyond compare, with flaming locks of auburn hair, with ivory skin and eyes of emerald green. Your smile is like a breath of spring, your voice is soft as summer rain, and I cannot compete with you, Jolene. He talks about you in his sleep, and there's nothing I can do to keep from crying when he calls your name, Jolene. And I can easily understand that he could easily take my man, but you don't know what he means to me, Jolene. Jolene, 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 Jolene. I'm begging of you, please don't take my man. Jolene, 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 Jolene. Oh, please don't take him just because you can. Now you could have your choice of man, but I can never love again. He's the only one for me, Jolene. I had to have this talk with you. My happiness depends on you and whatever you decide to do, Jolene. Jolene, 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 Jolene. I'm begging of you, please don't take my man. Jolene, 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 Jolene. Oh, please don't take him just because you can. Jolene!
Thanks, man.
Imagine this clapping multiplied by thousands, millions. That's fantastic. That was one. Thank you so much for doing that song for us. What are your thoughts coming out of the performance? What are your thoughts on that song?
Well, it's so cool. And with a lot of Dolly songs is that they're country and they're classic country, but they always drift into pop land. Just like, to me, they're really classic songs that can stand the test of time. I mean, I feel like, you know, playing it just on, say, steel string acoustic right now, it could be any number of folk singers that's out there, you know, making records at home, or it could be, I mean, granted that they're like amazing songwriters, right? Which there are. But it's a very classic song, and it just in any way recreated in any form, it stands so strong on its own. But that also, I mean, there's a lot of heartache in it, and it's like, I just wonder how her life was, because it's just so, the writing is so good.
Well, that's just it. I mean, well, first of all, it's paranoid, right? I mean, it really, really has a paranoia to it. And she says, oh, you know, there was a banker in our neighborhood, and I teased my husband about having a crush on her, but she's very mad. And then the name, it was like when she was still with Porter Wagoner, I guess a fan came up on stage for an autograph and she said, to whom do I make this out? It's Jolene. That's where she got the name. So it seemed like an innocent enough background from what she says. And of course, as a classic song, it starts with the chorus, which I feel is like a real classic country move. Like a lot of the Western swing stuff, a lot of Buck Owens stuff will just start with the chorus. Mm-hmm. It looks like we have a question from the audience. Let's see, this is coming from Colton on YouTube. And Colton is asking, Jaime, how were you introduced to Dolly and what was it about her that spoke to you?
How was I introduced to Dolly? Gosh, it probably was through the song Jolene. And it's so long ago that I can't quite remember the moment, but it was just, and then he asked what the impact was on me and songwriting and whatnot. Well, I just have always wanted to write songs that are that strong. And I think she's an incredible songwriter. It was like, I never thought, and also I'll put this out there that coming on to do this interview and do these Dolly songs, I was terrified because, it's a holy realm to play a Dolly song. The timbre of her voice, just where it sits, it's no one sounds like that. I don't sound like that. It's, you know, she's like a goddess. But yeah, I think it was, you know, because these songs are so strong and so enjoyable that she's definitely, I have tons of her records on vinyl, actually. And I have several favorites, but she's just always been one of my favorites.
It's funny being asked about how you were introduced her, because it seems like she's always been there, right?
Exactly. Right. Yeah.
Now, for some of our viewers who are watching right now, they might not be familiar with Dolly Parton, so we're going to give a little background on her. She's often referred to as the queen of country music, as we said at the top. She started as a songwriter. She actually spent a lot of time writing songs in the 60s. She wrote a few top 10 hits, including Pull It Off Until Tomorrow and Fuel to the Flame, and 41 career top 10 albums. That's a record for any artist. 25 songs reaching number one on country charts. That's a record for any female artist. She's tied with Reba on that one. 47 Grammy nominations, and she's apparently composed over 3,000 songs. So she just never stops. And speaking of never stopping, we have another question. This comes from Antonio. Jamie, have you ever had the fortune to perform with Dolly Parton?
No, not yet. And I say yet. Yes. Because, you know, it's one of those things that if you manifest what you want, visualize what you want, it can manifest. And, but no, that's a great question. Thank you. But not yet. I have not met the queen.
Yeah, I'm kind of holding out for when she comes on as a guest for Dwight's series.
With Dwight? Yeah.
Yeah, I figured that's my best
likely.
Shot. Now we move into another Dolly tune, and I'm going to remind the audience here that all the songs you hear today, you can go and learn on Fender Play right now. It's still free to sign up for 3 months, but the offer is only limited to a certain number of people. So take advantage of it before it's gone. While I learn how to complete a sentence, Jamie, will you honor us with your coat of many colors?
You're doing great. Yes, of course. All right, coat of many colors, and she is telling a story here. So I have.
Yes, she is.
Make sure that I don't wreck her beautiful lyrics. All right, so coat of many colors, let's see. Back through the years, I go wandering once again. Back to the seasons of my youth. I recall box rays someone gave us. How my mama put the rags to use. Hell, rags of many colors, and every piece was small. And I didn't have a coat, and it was way down in the fall. Mama sewed the rags together, sewing every piece with love. She made my coat of many colors that I was so proud of. She sewed, she told a story from the Bible she had read, about a coat of many colors, Joseph wore. And she said, perhaps this coat will bring you good luck and happiness. And I just couldn't wait to wear it, and Mama blessed that with a kiss. My coat of many colors that my mama made for me, made from only rags, but I wore so proudly. And although we had no money, I was as rich as I could be. My coat of many colors, my mama made for me. So with patches in my breeches and holes in both my shoes, with my coat of many colors, I hurried off to school. Just to find the others laughing and making fun of me. In my coat of many colors, my mama made for me. And I couldn't understand it, for I felt I was rich. And I told them of the love mama saw in every stitch. And I told them all the story mama told me, where she sewed. And my coat of many colors was worth more than all their clothes. And they didn't understand it, but I tried to make them see. one is only poor if they choose to be. Now I know we had no money, but I was rich as I could be. And my coat of many colors, my mama made for me. Made just for me. Just for me.
Very good. Ladies and gentlemen, that's how you perform a Dolly tune. A Dolly tune right there. So what are your thoughts on this song?
This is like the first, when there was mention of this interview, I just went through and I picked this song. And actually my mother recommended it to Coat of Many Colors. It's just so gorgeous. And it actually reminds me of my relationship with my mom. My mom sews some clothes for me and some costume for stage and works on suits for me. So I have a special connection to it, but it's so lovely, like her professing her love to her mother, and also to and just being like, it doesn't matter how much, like, for children this is an amazing song. It doesn't matter how much money you have, like, you are rich as you can be, you just make do with what you have. What a beautiful thing.
It's a beautiful thing, and a simple song, just two verses. I love that key change in that second verse.
I love the key change.
Now, Dolly Parton's arguably one of the most prolific songwriters of all time. As we mentioned, she's composed over 3,000 songs. We're talking a little more about her songwriting style. A question that I have is, what do you think her influence as a female in country and pop music is?
I would guess that she was influenced by what most country, by like the Carter family, just because, that's like the root of all American music right there, right? It's Carter family songs. And the her choruses are so anthemic, like, she really knows how to develop a chorus that everyone will be able to sing along to and want to sing along to and feel empowered by. You know, I'm sure she grew up singing gospel in the church, and that music too is about, channeling the power of the spirit, right? And so I would imagine that that's where, and maybe the passion and her upbringing and really having to make do with not a lot of, I doubt she had a lot of toys. I doubt they had a lot of assets or things to, like, entertain them. They had to entertain themselves. And I don't know, aside from, say, Carter family, what else I could reference, maybe besides gospel and Carter family, but I wonder. I'd love to pick her brain.
Yeah, it'd be great to have a conversation with her about that. I think you're right about that anthemic chorus. In fact, one song that comes to mind is another one that's on Fender Play, which is 9 to 5, which certainly it is an anthem. This song was a crossover hit. She became only the second woman to top both the country charts and the Billboard Hot 100. And that typewriting song, that typewriting noise, I think is her acrylic nails. There's just so much invention on that song. And I actually think it's working class. It's, there's pride. There's a cup of ambition as a phrase.
Yeah.
I say that, and I forget that that's from a Dolly Parton song. I just say cup of ambition all the time. That's almost like Chuck Berry good, as I was saying.
I'm going to start saying that because it's so cool.
It's good.
Like,
right?
I want to be cool too. Be like, yeah, I'll have a cup of ambition.
Yeah, exactly. As an artist in Nashville now, how do you feel that things are developing? How do you think that Dolly's helped you out? Like what paths has she blazed?
Man, just being a woman in country music and being the best. I just I couldn't thank her enough for what she's done, being a trailblazer but not only that, she's like, she writes, plays guitar, sings, and people don't realize too, like, she probably wrote a lot of parts that were on the recordings. And then if you see her perform on television or something, and she's just singing, that doesn't mean that she didn't write a bunch of parts that are on the recording. Right. I just think because she's so multifaceted and multi-talented, and then also being like graceful and beautiful, and not that beauty has anything to do with it, her grace and her presence really is what I'm referring to. she's classy, and it's like, and I can't say the same about myself, but that I appreciate her being there, like, and paving the way, you know, that she could be front a band, be a front woman in a band, you know, be the boss.
She's an executive producer of things. You're right. She runs her own show, and she's a very successful business person for sure. Okay. There's one more song available to learn on Fender Play, and that's the huge hit, I Will Always Love You. Now, this apparently, she, according to her notes, she wrote this on the same day as she wrote Jolene. So Dolly was really feeling it that day. There's a lot of range emotionally going on. It's for a classic song that was a hit when Dolly debuted it in 1974. And then, of course, there was another version that I believe you would like to speak about.
Oh, yeah, because, and this is the funniest thing ever, but the first time I ever heard this song, I Will Always Love You, was The Bodyguard, the movie with Kevin Costner, and Whitney Houston sings that. Wait, was she acting in it too, Whitney?
Yeah, oh yeah, she's
okay,
the lead.
That's right. And, so is this the 90s? Am I talking the 90s here?
You're talking the early mid-90s. And apparently Kevin Costner was the one that mentioned this song, or suggested this song for the movie.
Yeah. Oh, really?
Yeah.
Really? That's awesome. That's cool to know. So that's the first time I ever heard this song. And years, I didn't know that it was a Dolly Parton song. Mm-hmm. And like, I kind of feel like I'm not the only one from my generation.
Not.
Right? Okay. So, but, and I must say, I've got to give props where props due, in that Whitney Houston was an incredible singer, and she sang the heck out of the song. I don't know. Yeah. I almost swore, pardon. But I'm passionate about this subject, okay? So, yeah, that's the first time I heard this song. And, yeah.
Well, can we hear it?
Yeah. I will do my best. Dolly, forgive me. In Dolly we trust, right?
That's right.
If I should stay, I would only be in your way. So I'll go, but I know I'll think of you each step of the way. And dreamed of, and I wish you joy and happiness, but above all this I wish you love, and I love you.
That's it right there, everybody. That's Jaime Wyatt doing I Will Always Love You. That's fantastic.
Thanks. Wonderful.
Thank you so much for doing this. We have a question already from someone named Emily who's watching on YouTube, Jaime. She says, I want to start off by saying that you are an amazing singer.
Oh, thank you.
Also, who is your biggest inspiration for your music?
Yeah, there's so many musical inspirations, so many that I could like name off, you know, several. In country music, there's like a big bucket of them. Let's see, like Dolly, Loretta, Tammy Wynette, big time, Lucinda Williams. And then on the male side, it's like Graham Parsons, Buck Owens, Merle Haggard, and Waylon Jennings. And then I've got like a lot of classic soul influence, a lot of Otis Redding growing up, a lot of Sam Cooke and Aretha Franklin and God, there's so many. And then rock and roll, like who didn't love Elvis? I was a big Beatles fan, Rolling Stones. The list goes on and on, but it's like a lot of classic pop and country. Mm-hmm. And I hope that answered some of the questions. It's a lot of classics.
Yeah, it's several Mount Rushmores right there.
Yeah, for sure. Yeah, well said. Well said.
And IE, who's watching on YouTube, is asking, does Dolly primarily use finger picking or a flat pick? I think just from what I remember, she doesn't use a flat pick a whole lot. I know that she plays banjo, she plays auto harp. I mostly see her strumming with an open hand.
Claw hammer banjo.
Claw hammer, yeah, exactly. Mm-hmm. So I think for the most part, it's finger picking or at least strumming with the fingers or with the nails maybe.
I think she does use her acrylics, and actually she wouldn't be the only, a lot of male guitar players use acrylics mm-hmm. to strum as well.
Yeah.
I heard Tom Waits uses Lee Press-On now. And yeah, I've heard a lot because right? Well, you know, so I would guess Dolly uses her acrylics and they're probably really, really useful. Especially if she grew up playing claw hammer, like that is literally about your nails, you know, so it makes sense.
Nice demonstration there, by the way.
Oh, thanks. Yeah, play a little banjo. I play a little claw hammer.
Do you? I know this show's about Dolly Parton, but you're such a talented artist that I'd be remiss if I didn't ask to hear one of your songs. And I believe you're going to do something from your upcoming record.
Yes, of course. I'm going to do, of course. Yes, please.
Why yes?
Well, yes.
And I'll mention that this song here, when people do get the album, they'll hear a very special guest singer on this, the original outlaw herself, Jessie Coulter. Is that correct?
That is correct. And I thought it would be fitting to do this song on the show because Jessie Coulter was in that same era of Dolly and another really strong female singer, songwriter, and instrumentalist. So it was really cool to have her sing on this song. And the album was produced by Jessie's son, Shooter Jennings. So we kept it all in the family, but...
Very well.
So here, yes, this one's called Just a Woman. Oh, let's make sure this capo. That's guitar 101. Make sure your capo's set. All right.
That's right.
There's not a man in this world I would rather be. Flight on feathered wings. No, it's unlikely. No, it's unlikely. When you speak to me like a little girl, and we all need a friend in this changing world. Show me a door that does not close once open. Oh, I'm just a woman, nothing more. beauty and roses and pearls, they have a special place. No one, my dear, is beholden to such a silly game. Something so yearning, something for learning. Here I am, still at home, while you have your fun. When I gave and I give just a bit too much, but it's your kingdom and I have lost before I even try. I'm just one, nothing more, nothing less. I can't help what I'm doing. Supposed to be, is it a picture perfect dream? Well, I'm just a woman. What do I know?
And you know that's good. I know you know that's good.
I
like where the chords are sitting. I have fun.
I love you've got that dominant four chord in the sequence. And then at the end, you play my second favorite chord is a minor four chord.
Oh, when we do, wait, with this one, this.
Yes.
Oh, cool. Okay. Oh, I don't always know what they are. Like, I know chord chains, you know, and I'd say, oh, go to the four chord or whatever, but. That's cool. Okay, so I play the minor.
It's all the four. Yeah, well, we'll talk about it later. But okay, also, cool. Can I ask? I have something to ask. I have to ask you about the song, because when I first heard it, the key line to that song to me is the very first one, which is, "There's not a man in this world I would rather be." And as soon as I heard that line, I thought, "Man, I'm all in. I'm all in. Right. Whatever this person wants to say next, I'm listening." Did you know that that line? I mean, did it start there, how did you build from that line, or did it just show up?
No, not even, it just showed up. It came pretty quick, but like all I had for a while was the hook, like just a woman, what do I know? And and then I just started playing and it just kind of came to me. So I wasn't even, and I didn't even think it was that great, so thanks.
It's almost like this song that invites this discussion, the way that Stand By Your Man did. When Tammy Wynette sang that decades ago, people are still debating the meaning of that song. So I hope you're part of some sort of a long, long discussion, because I think that song's worth it.
Well, thanks. I just, like I said, I've been listening to Dolly and Tammy and Loretta and all the classics like that. And I just hope that somewhere it kind of like goes in my brain and spits out this way. So I appreciate being compared to
Tammy. So is that an example of how Dolly, maybe an artist like Dolly Parton has influenced you as an artist?
Well, yeah, it's just like it's always in rotation. But you know, it's like there's also so much material of hers that I haven't studied and that I'm just learning now. Because I think for a while I only knew the hits. And actually on a lot of artists, I would just play the hits because I'm like, I love hit songs, right? I love anthems. Sure. And so I'm embarrassed to say that, like, I really now recently, because of this, I've dug deeper into Dolly. And I'm super happy about it. Yes.
The deep catalog.
Yes.
The bluegrass stuff is great. The gospel stuff is great. Yeah, there's a lot of wonderful material there.
Oh, I got to delve into the gospel stuff. I'm a sucker for the gospel stuff.
Well, I want to remind our audience that if you want to learn any of these Dolly songs that you've heard in this episode, check them out on Fender Play. It's free to sign up still for 3 months, and there's no better time to learn. Now, for you players watching at home, we're going to give you some things you can work on after the show is over to help hone your skills. These are some simple things you can work on, but for more lessons and learn all the songs you heard in this episode, make sure to check out Fender Play. Now, I'm going to assign the homework. I rarely get to do this. For the beginners, strum the chords to 9 to 5 at a speed with which you're comfortable. There's just 4 chords, and they're all major chords. For the intermediate, play Coat of Many Colors at full speed. And for the advanced, play and sing Jolene at full speed. And if you can get that intro, then God bless you. I think it's Chip Young that played that thing. It's you got to have that quarter note thumping.
Oh yeah.
I'm not playing it right, so I've got to sign up for Fender Play now. I want a big thank you to you, Jaime Wyatt. Thank you so much for
doing this.
We're going to bring you back a little bit for our final chord. But before we get to that, can you tell everyone what you have going on right now?
Oh, yeah. Yes. I'm about to release a record on the end of this month. So May 29th, I have an album coming out on New West Records. And the album's called Neon Cross. And I'm really excited about it. Like I said, Jesse Coulter is that song we just played on it. Jesse Coulter sings with me. It's great. We got a lot of country music in there. We got some rock and roll influence country on there. Got a little soul influence country in there. So.
And I want everyone to know that the title track, Neon Cross, to my ears, it's about the best thing you're going to come across this year. That track kills me. It's this great cross of pop and rock and country. And I think you guys, you and Shooter and everyone on that should be very, very proud. It's really, really special.
Thank you,
track.
Eugene. Well, thank you. Appreciate it.
Got it. Okay, so stick around. We'll bring you back for the final chord. Now, remember, too, if you want the awesome hat that I have on display here. So let's go with the hat, everyone. How am I looking, Jaime, with this?
You look great, actually. That looks killer on you.
I feel like a relief pitcher right now. This is pretty good. if you want this hat, you can get it for 30% off with the offer code Jolene. But you only have 24 hours, so act fast. Now, we also have a special Mother's Day sweepstakes. And to tell us about it, I'm going to bring on the friendly and the mysterious Dylan Caligiuri.
Hey,
what's with the hat?
Wow. Hey, wait a minute. You should have told me. I would have coordinated with you. Wow.
This is so awkward. Welcome, Dylan. Now, first, tell us about this Mother's Day sweepstakes.
Yes, we've got a big sweepstakes going on. It's called Do It For Your Mama. And basically, we want you to learn a song this weekend for your mom or a loved one, right? And as a gift to them. And if you do so, you're entered in to win a 60s Vintera Mustang. All you have to do is open Fender Play and complete a song, and that's it. The winner is going to be picked on the upcoming Monday. So do it for your mama.
That's a great opportunity. Those Vintera Mustangs are very, very cool. Yeah, check the link in the description here for the sweepstakes details. Now, for you viewers who watch us each week, you know we also like to give away some gear each week in the Fender Play giveaway. So if you're joining us just for the first time, Dylan, tell them all about that.
Yeah, so each week we give away guitars, a guitar, a bass. We give away an amplifier. I mean, this is not just little stuff that the winner gets. And basically, you get to choose from those options on your own. We've given away quite a few at this point, and all you have to do is basically enter to win by getting 3 streaks, which is 3 7-minute sessions on Fender Play, and you automatically enter to win every week. So.
This is very, very cool. And can you tell us who won this week?
All right. Are you ready for this? Let's do it.
Yeah, I got this.
Here we go. We've got Don M. Don M. Come on down. Congratulations, Don.
Congratulations, Don. Way to go. All right. So just to recap, if you're a Fender Play user this week, you have 2 chances to win a free guitar, which is pretty nuts. Now, of course, another perk of being on Fender Play is access to our community of 45,000 learners. It's a friendly and supportive community where people share their progress, they ask questions, they show off their gear, and you also get access to our instructors who are hosting live office hours and answering questions 7 days a week. Dylan, you got some shout-outs for us this week?
Yeah, so a couple of people we want to mention again. Tons of great new content that are on there and great people that are helping other people. Liv Fox posted a video of progress with the song Zombie by the Cranberries after Matt Lake did a Office Hours on Monday, and it was fantastic. Yeah, so she did a great job. Excellent, Liv. Emily Blake, who shared her progress after 3 weeks. She's already playing through the G, C, and E minor chords. So pretty darn good, Emily. That's right. And then again, we've got an At Home this week with Molly Miller, who's a great friend of mine, and Jensen, who's coming up, Jensen Tranny. So they're going to be commiserating on all things guitar. So that's coming up on Friday. So make sure you stay tuned for that.
Very cool. Dylan, you're also here to tell us what's new on the site, since we're always adding new things to learn. Can you tell us about anything that's new this week?
Yeah. So, you know, a couple of the songs that we heard on there, are actually all the songs we heard are on the site, right? One of the ones, Coat of Many Colors, which is obviously a really beautiful song. So we've got a song lesson that's on there, but we've also got the full song lesson. So if you're learning the song lesson, if you're learning G, C, and D, this is a great way to get an exercise on just getting through those and have a great song that you can learn. If you're ready to jump to the full song, you can now learn how to play this with hammer-ons and bass note strums. You're gonna end up with. And the cool thing about that is,
I'm watching.
You can try using your pick, or you can try using your fingers, and you have options basically to decide how you want to do that. So just like we were talking about early, Dolly used her fingers a lot, but people also use their picks. So,
Well,
that's another awesome. Thing you want to check out is Heartbreak Hotel. And this is a full song lesson. So a lot of people wonder the mystique of Elvis's guitar, or his guitar playing, also his guitarist, is pretty much taking all that was awesome about country and rock and roll, and blues, and creating rock and roll as we know it today. So this is a great song to learn several techniques with. So you've got. So it's got like quite a few different techniques, and you can hear how the solo is actually copying the vocal line there, and that's where solos generally originated from. So you can kind of work at the origin of this stuff and pull it all together from these songs.
No, that's what I love about that. That's a great way to. If people ask me like how do I start soloing? How do I something? Just play the melody of the song. Start there, and you'll find yourself kind of
embellish close to it.
Well, thank you very, very much, Dylan. I appreciate that. And also a huge thank you to our guest, Jaime Wyatt, for stopping by live from Nashville.
Great job, Jaime.
Thank you.
Jaime, you'll be getting your hat soon, I'm pretty sure.
Yeah, I'm stoked. I love me a trucker hat. And that's like a pro trucker hat. Or do you think that's more...
It's like a veteran hat. I feel like I'm impersonating our mutual friend Ben over there in Nashville with this hat.
Oh, for sure. Yeah, he always rocks those hats.
This is, yeah. So, and also, again, thank you to Dylan. Join us next week for another episode of Fender Play Live. Keep safe, keep practicing, and see you next time. Jaime, join us for this big G chord. You ready? Here we go.
Yes, sir.